And welcome back. Of course, Weekend Prime continues now with tributes to celebrate South African jazz giant Sibongile Khumalo. She will be laid to rest tomorrow. Mangoma, as she is affectionately known to those who are close to her, was a musical dynamo with immeasurable abilities covering classical, jazz, opera and traditional South African music. Now, she died last week after a lengthy illness. One of her closest admirers and family friend is IFP President Emeritus Dr. Mangosuthu Buthelezi. He joins us now to share his fondest memories of Dr. Khumalo. Ntwana, good evening, and thank you very much for joining us tonight on Weekend Prime.
Good news. Let's
talk about your relationship with the Mngoma family and the closeness of that relationship, but also your memories and encounter with Sibongile growing up.
Yes. You know, when I was doing my trick, that is 1946 and 47, at Adams College, then Mr. Kabi Mngoma arrived with Wilkinson Tamsanga Kambule, you know, that wizard of mathematics. And they were doing a post-matric course in teaching. Mr. Mngoma then trained us. I was in his choir, the male voice choir. And I remember singing Grandfather's Clock. We stopped short when the old man died. And also in the mornings, we used to do exercises with him. And he also taught me boxing. And then what happened later is that he was appointed a lecturer or professor of music at the University of Zululand. And I was chancellor of that university for 21 years. So Professor Kabi Mngoma and Mrs. Mngoma and their two children, Sibongile and Lindumuzi, would stop here. And since they were interested in music, and my mother was a well-known musician who had already performed for what was called Zulu Radio during those days, they would ask her to play the Zulu musical bow, which she played for them and sang many songs, you know.
Yeah.
And my mother's repertoire was really just like that of Sibongile Khumalo.
Yeah.
Because although she was very good in our indigenous music, but she was also good in choral music, and she played many instruments. Of the Western instruments, she played the auto harp, she played the piano, she vemmed the piano, she played stolotolo and so on. So there was that bond between us, you know, with the Mngoma family all these years. Then Miss Sandra de Villiers appeared on the scene and connected with Sibongile Khumalo and Professor Mzilikazi Khumalo, and they said they were dreaming of putting together an opera on my mother's life,
yes, you know,
which was the first African opera ever.
Yeah.
And then at that time, then she played the role of my mother and singing all my mother's songs. And there is actually a CD where they sing Ungcwele together, not on the same disc.
Yes.
But actually on the, you know, she sing, my mother sings it and then she sings it. And it's very interesting because they backed up my mother with an orchestra long after she died.
Yes.
And actually, the rendition of this song by Sibongile Khumalo is absolutely fantastic.
How did it feel for you when she came? And I remember that story where she says, I want to redo this music of Princess Makoko Gadini Zulu because it's a music that I grew up with. And when she came to the family to say, this is what I want to do, and I'm sure she did it with your blessing, how did you feel with the final product of what she produced?
Actually, Ms. Mdula, I feel it's the other way around. In fact, Sibongile Khumalo was, you know, without any shyness, would admit that she was inspired by my mother to choose music as a career. So it was not the other way around.
Yeah.
In fact, she was very proud of the fact that she was inspired by mother's singing.
Yeah.
To be what she was. Yes.
Yeah. And your interaction with her music, How do you find it? I know you are a musical person yourself. You like to sing. And when you listen to the sound of Sibongile Khumalo, what does it bring for you?
I mean, really, I don't think I can compare to anyone I know. And her music is actually stands out alone because, as I say, her repertoire is actually so wide-ranging that she can sing jazz, as you were saying. She can sing indigenous music. She can sing classical music. In fact, her father was a soloist himself in his own right. As I said, that I actually sang under his patron in the male voice choir at Adams College. So really, her music. In fact, even in my handbag, even now, I've got one of her discs, which when I travel, I always put it on as I travel, because I really find her music absolutely, irresistible, and actually fantastic.
Now, when you heard of the passing of this iconic, really talented artist, a soprano, singer, writer, I mean, what message did you have and do you have now for the family on her passing?
Well, I know that none of us is indispensable, but my feeling was that shall we as a nation ever have another Sibongile Khumalo? I mean, she was so unique, really, that no one can argue about that. That this thing has hit us very hard here as a family. You know, I've already sent my condolences to her daughter, and of course, even tomorrow, I hope that my message at the funeral will also be read. I find it devastating that I will never see her again, because, I mean, you know, I'm 92 years. She was only 62. She was at the prime of her life. Mm. And it's a big loss for our nation. In Parliament, I was very surprised when the Minister of Basic Education, Minister Motsekga, was telling me that some of my mother's songs actually are sang in all the schools, you know, actually for competition in all the schools in South Africa. That's the contribution which Sibongile, I think, and my mother did, and which should always remain as legacy of both of them.
And finally, before we let you go, exactly that, how do we ensure that those traditions, that legacy, stays on for generations to come, and they get to learn about this music and this particular way of expression?
Now, my sadness, you know, Mr. Mduli, is the fact that that genius, Professor Mzilikazi Khumalo, that he's no longer active, because this man is wonderful, because I think that more than any other composers, I mean, there are many African composers, and I admire all of them, but I think he was very unique, in fact, in actually transposing my mother's music, you know, and actually having it orchestrated. And actually, I remember that the backing by that outstanding conductor, Richard Koch, who could, you know, who backed up, you know, this music, which was unique in the history of South Africa. I hope that it doesn't disappear, but I think she has immortalized it in a way. My hope at my age is that she, Sibongile Khumalo, more than anyone, and as utilizes as much as Professor Mzilikazi Khumalo.
Yeah.
Prince Mangosuthu. And also, I admire, thank you.
We're out of time. I'm going to have to leave it there. I do appreciate you taking this time and sending your tribute tonight. Thank you for your time.